My name is James Mubin. I'm 10th grade, Mandela House.
My name is Cynthia Jada, 10th grade, Schomburg House.
A memorable lesson that one of my Eagle educators told me, in 9th grade, Ms. Ahmed, English, we conducted a trial. We learned the concept of how, in the process of how, like a lawyer or a lawyer and stuff will go through to conduct a trial. We did started prepping our witnesses, getting facts, just the setting of a courtroom too, stuff like that.
I would like to piggyback off of Jay Lubin. I also think that a memorable lesson we learned was also conducting the mock trial. We read a book, Animal Farm, and we had to trial Napoleon for murder and treason. And like he said, we conducted a trial and we were attorneys, lawyers, we did counterclaims, claims. We proved our thesis. We got facts, evidence from the books, textual evidence to back our facts up. And it was really important to us and very useful because it could also work in life in places where you need to back up something, information in a text, a reading, a writing, anything. So I agree with you moving on that.
Usually on certain days we work in groups and she shows a demonstration and then we have to work together to figure it out. Sometimes go back to the text, get the information. She would just basically put a model and we have to follow it, basically.
I'd like to piggyback on Jada Lubin also here that we were quite familiar with it already because of prior years of knowledge and how to do stuff, but she basically she gave us a model and we had to basically, she gave us hints and ways to get it, but she didn't give us the answer. She wanted us to get it ourselves. So she would tell us to go back in the text and then give us a page range, from page 70 to 77, but we would have to find the textual evidence. And the way she explained what a counterclaim was, she basically broke down the words. A claim, we already knew what a claim was, and we knew, and then counter something is to go back on something, so we understood what the concept of counterclaim was. So that's how she taught us.
It helped me understand what actually happens in the real courtroom. It's hard to convince somebody to overturn a decision. It's more than just you just saying I didn't do it. You really have to back it up and show evidence to prove that you're right or you're or they're wrong.
So it was very informative, and that basically it was very informative on how things go down in the courtroom, and it made me very open-minded to things in the courtroom because like he said, it's not just an easy process, and every judge has to because of our classroom, it was only one judge, Ms. Ahmed. But in the real courtroom, there has to be, all judges have to come to an agreement, or if not, there's a new trial. But it was really hard to try to convince Ms. Ahmed because with the witnesses we had to have certain evidence. If we didn't have certain evidence, it was discredited. And if it was discredited, then our opinion was not valid. So it gave points to the other team. Sometimes the other team gave points to us. So in the end, it was really informative and we got to learn a lot from it. I think it was a mix because, you can't learn anything by yourself. But I think that she guided us through the way so that we can be able to do it. So I think it was a mix of her teaching us and her giving us the time to teach ourselves as well. But she also allowed us to be dependent in it after she taught us the components and basics of it and to find out the advanced more versions.
During the trial, it's more like us. She was just listening, just being a judge. But how Cynthia was saying, during the process of building up our case towards the trial, she was very helpful. But it was a mixture, you were saying, it was a mixture because she was wasn't holding our hand the whole way. She was actually giving us our own path, basically. We could have picked whatever we wanted to do and how to conduct it, or if we wanted to waste our time, she was being a teacher, but she wasn't being a parent.
I think the best way I feel that I learned was more hands-on, more interactive, because when I'm hands-on and interactive, I get to understand it more instead of just hearing it, because when I get to touch the items on the witness stand, or I get to actually write and do the process, is more, I get it, I get to comprehend it more. But if it's just told to me, I won't fully get the basis of it, so it'll be more complicated to me.
For me, it's the opposite. Like, I'm basically like, I like to speak, I like to, like, I can understand when you're telling me it. Like, I think my voice, like, how I articulate myself is better than, like, in my writing and stuff, because I can, like, get off my thinking easier, maybe, like, my concept of what I'm thinking, my opinion, easier than if I'm writing. Like, people might not understand through my writing, but if I present it to you by speaking, you can understand.
Well, this is all the time that we have. Thank you again for your ideas, and this is going to be extremely helpful as we, you know, help, as we support our Eagle educators and support you all to be, you know, your best self in the classroom. So thank you again for your time, and we wish you the best in all of your endeavors in the upcoming